The deputy town clerk in Fort Porto is in a spot of bother over COVID relief cash. It's understood members of parliament on the COVID task force put John Bosco Rusoke on the spot after it emerged that some of the recipients got double the amount of money that they were supposed to receive.
Fort Porto deputy clerk John Bosco Rusoke was left speechless and could only try to dodge the questions. This forced Kashari North Member of Parliament Basil Bataringaya to ask him to take an oath.
I, Bosoke John Bosco, do solemnly swear that the evidence shall be touching the matter before the Parliamentary Committee on public accounts, central and local, shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me God.
Bataringa says they found names on the list that appeared more than once. The team said they would verify the list with the Ministry of Gender and the Office of the Prime Minister to find out if there was connivance.
A very long discussion with the Fort Porto team of stakeholders, and there are a few findings that we have made. There are a few documents that we have picked for review. But key is that we found some repeating names of people who benefited more than once, twice, three, sometimes five times. So since we do not have enough time to contact these people, the good thing is that they have telephone numbers, and we are going to verify together with the lists of gender, Ministry of Gender and Office of the Prime Minister, against their NIN numbers.
After giving you the beneficiaries, are you aware that those people never got the money, but in actual sense, you ended up giving different people where the chairpersons are not involved? Are you aware?
I didn't hear the rest of the statement. I'm requesting that allow me submit what is ready today and at the same time seek your ladies. When you can submit what is not ready.
Was made in such a way that it was only and only the NIN number that was to be used in order for A or B or C to get money. Then it goes without saying therefore that any other criteria, either the name or the telephone number to the system was immaterial.
There was also an issue on the 8 million shillings extended for facilitation, and the MPs now insist on an audit, and if a fraud is proven, they want the law to take its course.
Yes, on the 8 million that was sent for to facilitate the team in this transaction or administration of the COVID funds, right from the generation of risks up to the payment time, there are very many people that were supposed to be involved. So we have found doubtable documents of payments.
Giving it to them and say, sign here. And some money was given them, even without explaining what it was for. I'm here telling you that me, personally, I never attended any meeting they are talking about. I was never part of that plan, work plan they are talking about.
William Museveni, the Member of Parliament for Bukwekula South in Mubende, questioned the team spirit among Fort Porto leaders. He noted that the office of the mayor and that of the RCC were not involved in the process of distributing the money.
Well, found out that the mayor was not involved, fully involved in the exercise, even the office of the RDC. Well, found out that it was the deputy town clerk who was manning each and everything. It was one man's show.
The mayor for Porto Tourism City is concerned. We totally have no knowledge about how names of the people were compiled, how they were verified, how much, and whether or not they got the money. We even don't have, we even don't know the number of the people who benefited.
This story was compiled by Doreen Nasima for the news in Fort Portal.